Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Warm and a joyous welcome to each of you to partake in the glorious golden jubilee of the religious profession of our sister Jyoti. Today, we the sisters of St. Charles Borromeo marvel at the marvelous works of God, joyously beholding the blessings of the Lord, enthusiastically singing the praises of the Lord, gratefully thanking the greatness of the Lord, and speculating at the wonders God has done in the life of our dear sister Jyoti for the past 50 golden years of grace. Dear fathers, brothers and sisters, on this day of thanksgiving, we have gathered here to celebrate and to give thanks for the person of Sister Jyoti, who celebrates 50 years of her religious life. We are filled with a sense of jubilation, joy, and gratitude. Congratulations to dear Sister Jyoti for this unique milestone. Jubilee is a time for looking back and looking forward. The book of Leviticus depicts the spirit of Jubilee as an occasion of a grateful remembrance of the past events, of rejoicing for the graces received, of recognition of God's faithfulness. Dear Sister Jyoti, the journey of 50 years is not simply a journey through a string of days and years. Rather, your journey has been surrounded and intertwined by the intimacy and a relationship, mystery and a secret growth. The God who called you has accompanied you to live the spirit of your consecration. Dear Sister Jyoti, today we celebrate you, your occasion, your call, your life of service, but above all, we celebrate God, His call, His faithfulness, His mercy, which has been the anchor of your life. God did not see your ability or disability, but your availability to fulfill your role for the kingdom of God. We appreciate your commitment and dedication for the past 50 beautiful years of vowed life. Your deep faith has enabled you to live your S in a variety of roles, which you fulfilled with dedication and responsibility. You are precious to us, and we thank you for your generous service to the society in different places, to various people in the mission of the church. God's divine power has given you everything you need to live a true religious life through the knowledge of the one who has called you to share in his glory and goodness. With hearts filled with gratitude, we join you to relive those special moments, hours, days, months and years. On this day, we remember all your dear and near ones who have nurtured you and supported you for all the past years, and above all, have been generous enough to sacrifice you for a greater call. There is no better way to give thanks to God than celebrating the Eucharist. Let us pledge our prayerful support as Sister Jyoti stands at the gate of tomorrow, facing the years ahead. Let us surrender all those who have been a part of the life of our dear Sister Jyoti. As she moved towards the table of thanksgiving, let's rise and join in this celebration, praising the Triune God. Kindly rise.
As we celebrate the faithfulness of God to Sister Jyoti for the last 50 years, we also celebrate Sister Jyoti's fidelity to her master for the last 50 years. My dear brothers and sisters, all of us are called to serve, to be faithful to the Lord. If at all we have failed in our commitment, let us ask God's pardon as we say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us of our many sins, and may He bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of your adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses on Mount Sinai, saying, "Speak to the people of Israel and say to them, when you enter the land that I am giving you, the land shall observe a Sabbath for the Lord. 6 years shall sow your field, and 6 years you shall prune your vineyard and gather in their yield. But in the 7th year, there shall be a Sabbath to complete rest, of complete rest for the land, a Sabbath for the Lord. You shall not sow your field or prune your vineyard. You shall count of 7 weeks of years, 7 times 7 years, so that the period of 7 weeks of years gives 49 years. Then you shall have the trumpet sounded aloud on the 10th day of the 7th month, on the Day of Atonement. You shall have the trumpet sounded throughout all the land. And you shall hallow the 50th year, and you shall proclaim liberty throughout the land to all its inhabitants. It shall be a jubilee for you. You shall return, every one of you, to your family. That 50th year shall be a jubilee for you. You shall not sow or reap the aftergrowth or harvest the unpruned vines, for it is a jubilee. It shall be holy to you. You shall eat only what the field itself produces." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. a reading from the first letter of St. John. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. And by this we know that we have come to know him, if we keep his commandments. Whoever says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, in him truly the love of God is perfected. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, the two disciples told what had happened on the road and how Jesus was known to them in the breaking of the bread. As they were talking about these things, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace to you." But they were startled and frightened and thought they saw a spirit. And he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? See my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a spirit does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. And while they still disbelieved for joy and were marveling, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate before them. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ should suffer and on the third day rise from the dead, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins should be proclaimed in his name to all nations beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, as Sister Jyoti Philip celebrates her golden jubilee today, I am sure Her song of praise and thanksgiving wells up from deep within her heart, just like the great song of our Blessed Mother. We are all gathered here today to join Sister Jyoti in this song of gratitude and worship. Pope Francis says that on the occasion of a jubilee, one is called to look back on the journey traveled with joy and thanksgiving, and look ahead to the future with hope and surrender. For all that has been, thanks. For all that shall be, yes. We can be sure that these are the sentiments of Sister Jyoti today. What do we celebrate on the jubilees? Be it silver, gold, diamond, or platinum. Has the jubilarian achieved the jubilee year of consecration on her own? No. Everything is a grace from God. It does not matter to God whether we deserve it or not. God's grace flows into our lives abundantly. The perseverance in our calling for 25 years, 50 years, or any number of years is not our individual achievement to be celebrated, but it is God's grace for which we need to be filled with gratefulness towards Him who has called us, kept us, led us, sustained us, supported us, strengthened us, and saved us. The centrality of any jubilee celebration is not the individual's achievement, but rather a grateful remembrance, anamnesis, of God's gratuitous call and His constant accompaniment in our life. We just heard the gospel that the disciples of Emmaus told the first community of believers gathered together in Jerusalem about what had happened to them on the road and how Jesus had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. Our life is a journey. Often it resembles a journey to Emmaus. Like the two disciples, we do not journey alone. We journey together with our families, our communities, and our congregations. And as we journey together, we hold spiritual conversations about the beloved of our soul, our Lord Jesus Christ. It is then that Jesus comes where we are, exactly where we are, and makes Himself a part of our conversation and companionship. He opens the scriptures to us in such a way that our hearts begin to burn. He accompanies us every step of our way, and when enveloped by darkness around us and filled with darkness within, we cry out to Him, "Stay with us, Lord, for it is getting dark." He listens to our plea and makes His home with us, sits at the table with us, and breaks the bread with us. Every day without fail, when we recognize Him face to face, immense joy fills our hearts. There is new enthusiasm, new courage, new hope, new strength, new zeal, and new vision. St. Ignatius of Loyola calls it spiritual consolation. Sometimes we too, like the disciples, may not recognize the Lord. We may be afraid, and the Lord may have to show us His glorious wounds. But ultimately, what is most important is that we clearly hear the Lord saying, "Shalom." It is a Hebrew word translated as peace. But that is poor, inadequate translation of the word shalom. Shalom is more than peace. It is a total, integral and fundamental sense of well-being. This is the gift of the risen Lord to us. It is this gift that makes us fruitful for the kingdom of God. This is to my Father's glory that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. Our life as religious and what we do in ministry as his disciples are all for God's glory and not for our own. Dear Sister Jyoti Philip, as you are here before God today, we join you in thanking God for each and every blessing you have received in your life. We thank God for helping you sail through all the ups and downs of life. We thank God for persevering you in His love. We thank God for His presence in you, and because of His indwelling presence in you, and only because of that, you have persevered in your calling to this day. We thank God for the gift of shalom to you. We thank God for the abundant fruitfulness of your life as a religious and as a servant of Christ's mission. We thank God for the miracles He has worked in your life. The miracles are always there. If we really open our eyes to see them everywhere, and today you, Sister Jubilarian, are a living miracle. Miracle that proclaims loud and clear God's mighty hand in guiding you all these 50 years of religious consecration. As a branch, dear sister, you have remained faithful to the vine and have borne fruit in your various ministries. During these 50 years of her exemplary dedicated life, Sister Jyoti has done for the Lord what is possible. But the Lord has done through her even what is impossible. As I went through the second reading to prepare my reflection, I was indeed struck by the word love. This word love is in fact the impetus for our religious life. The word love motivates us and propels us to live our commitment faithfully. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. We hear the same resonating in the Gospel of John. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Now remain in my love. Our life as a religious is our way of responding to God's love. So this life which you and I have chosen is a way of remaining in God and remaining in His love. We need no other reason to choose this way of life except the unwavering conviction that God loves us unconditionally and steadfastly. When we look around us in our contemporary society today, we are indeed bewildered that the rate of breakups in relationships and divorce in marriages. It all begins well when a boy and girl fall in love, but as the relationship builds, both of them find it difficult to remain in love, to persevere in love, and failure to resolve the difficulty results in breakup. Permanent commitment in the relationship or in any other aspect of life is unfortunately becoming irrelevant and rare, a thing of past. Unfortunately, this is becoming increasingly evident in religious life and priesthood as well. Look at what is happening in church today. It all begins well when a boy joins the seminary and a girl enters the convent. But as the years pass by and they go through the various stages of formation, they find it difficult to remain in the Lord's love, to persevere in love, and failure to resolve that difficulty results in either leaving the priesthood or religious life, or worse still, using one's life as a priest or a nun for the self-interest, self-love, self-accomplishment, self-actualization, and self-will. Sister Jyoti Philip, you are a living testimony of remaining in love, perseverance in calling, and perpetual commitment. Your first love is Jesus, and that first love has remained till today. The only love, and that is what we celebrate today in you, remaining in Jesus in these last 50 years. You have put your hand to the plough and not looked back since then. Praise be to God. It is absolutely certain that Jesus Christ is our first love, and that is why we are here. But then we need to ask ourselves, if Christ is the only love in whom we remain and whom we with all our heart, soul and mind love, or is this love fading because of our obsession with self, ego, persons, positions, power, prestige, popularity, privilege, pressures, and even possessions? We also need to ask ourselves if we love our brothers and sisters here in the community as well as those outside, especially the poor, the needy, and those on the peripheries, as much as we love ourselves. This is our life, our mission, and this is how we are meant to be. Saint Catherine of Siena says, if you are who you are meant to be, you will set the world on fire. Indeed, Sister Jyoti, religious life, religious like you, really set the world on fire. Not with a huge flash, but with silent service. What would happen if there were no sisters? Pope Francis said, with his characteristic departure from his prepared notes, sisters in the hospitals, sisters in the missions, sisters in the schools. One can't imagine it. They are the leaven that carry the people of God forward. We can't also imagine the world without St. Charles Borromeo's, because with your unique mission and charism, your presence in the world is indispensable, and your contribution to society is irreplaceable. Today we share the thought of Pope Francis and say, sisters, you have been a leaven in this society and have carried people of God forward. Summing it all up, I would say, Jubilee is a feast of praise and thanksgiving. It is a day of joy. On a Jubilee day, the jubilarian looks back with gladness and gratitude. She also looks ahead with courage and confidence. As she looks back on the journey traversed, she realizes that she was never alone at any time along the journey. There were always so many people accompanying her, and above all, there was the one who never left her. He had chosen her, called her, consecrated her, and sent her, the Lord. The Emmaus journey has been a paradigm for the journey of our jubilarian. It is a journey to the Lord and also with the Lord that the jubilarian is rejoicing over and is thankful for. I will never leave you. I will not forget you. I will not abandon you. I will always be with you. How many times have you not heard these words of consolation and comfort, of strength and security from the Lord in your prayer, particularly in times of distress and doubt, of discouragement and disappointment, of darkness and desolation? Has not the Lord been close to you, filling you with hope, courage and strength? When, like Peter, drowning in the water, you have cried out, "Lord, save me, for I am being lost." Has not the Lord stretched out his hand to catch hold of you, to lift you up and to steady you, saying, "Why did you doubt, you woman of little faith?" It is to this Lord, dear Sister Jyoti, that you sing your Magnificat today. "He who is mighty has done great things for you," and we want to join you in this song. Dear sister, today what you are really celebrating is this: the Lord's unfailing faithfulness to you and your own generous response to his constant call to belong to him alone, to love him alone, to recognize him alone as your treasure, and to acknowledge him alone as your true master, and to serve him alone with all your strength. We join you in thanking the Lord for all that he has accomplished in you and through you throughout these 50 years of your faithful, dedicated, committed life and ministry as a religious. Let me conclude by invoking the Old Testament blessing upon you. May the Lord love and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and shield you. May he continue to journey along with you and keep you safe always. Amen. Please stand to profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead and ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, as we thank God for the life and the commitment of Sister Jyoti, we pray in a special way for her intentions, for her near and dear ones, for her congregation, for her community, and her larger community, the Church.
Let our response be: Lord, we pray for our Pope Francis, all the bishops, priests, religious and lay faithful. May all be filled with your spirit and imitate the good shepherd in their love and care for the flock entrusted to their care, we pray.
Lord, we place our trust in you. Keep us in you.
We pray for our congregation and every sister. Fill us with your Holy Spirit to fulfill our mission with love and compassion. We also pray for vocations to religious life and priesthood. We pray. Lord, we pray for Sister Jyoti as she thanks you profoundly for 50 years of grace-filled life and blessings. Lord, we ask you to shower on her graces, peace and joy, especially good health. Bless her family members and grant eternal rest to her beloved parents. We pray. We pray for all the people suffering from and affected by COVID-19 pandemic. We also remember the vast number of doctors, nurses, and all those who reach out selflessly to help and care for them. May we be inspired to do likewise. We pray. Lord, on this auspicious day, we pray for our main celebrant, Bishop Francis Saravo, and all the concelebrants. We are grateful to them for offering this Eucharist meaningfully. Lord, bless their priestly ministry abundantly, we pray. Lord, bless all of us gathered here, participating in this Eucharistic celebration. May your Holy Spirit fill each one of us to continue your mission of love and peace. We pray.
Heavenly Father, these are some of our prayers expressed to you in words. There are many others which are hidden in our hearts known to you. Bless all of them, especially when they reflect the values of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen. Sacrifice of joy, we bring our gifts, O Lord, in answer to your call. We offer up to you the sacrifice of joy.
Oh, brothers and sisters, that this your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to the Lord, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you, yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power of the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of His saving passion of Your Son, His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to His second coming, we offer You in thanksgiving His holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of Your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death You will to reconcile us to Yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of Your Son and filled with His Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May He make of us an eternal offering to You, so that we may obtain an inheritance with Your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Charles Borromeo, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in Your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity Your pilgrim church on earth, with Your servant Francis our Pope and Francis our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people You have gained for Your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom You have summoned before You. In Your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to Yourself all Your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to You at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to Your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of Your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom You bestow on the world all that is good.
Through Him and with Him and in Him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is Yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of Your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, You said to Your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our many sins, but look on the faith of Your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with Your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share the peace with one another. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Sure.
with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you have pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks.